Sean, thank you for joining me today to discuss the newly released Internet of Healthcare report. And for our community tuning in, this is the first of a series of conversations we'll be having with industry leaders who are able to provide valuable context and insights on the report's findings. Our conversations will include important perspectives from healthcare executives, clinicians, administrators, and patients as we all continue the incredibly important work of creating the Internet of Healthcare for our nation. So, Sean, this report really brings to life the onslaught of disconnected data healthcare is facing and the consequential side effects it is having on burnout and negative patient impacts, such as misdiagnosis. So let's first talk about the dire situation in the healthcare industry. And let me call out some key statistics from the report, and then I have a question for you. 92% of clinicians agree that too much time spent on administrative tasks is a major contributor to healthcare worker burnout. And 50% of administrative staff have seen an increase in the amount of manual data entry in the past 12 months. And lastly, nearly half of executives fear increased employee turnover if their organization is not able to increase its use of AI in the next 1 to 2 years. So with that, Sean, given the current situation we're in, an untenable amount of data without proper connectivity and automation, where do we go from here?
Well, thanks, Mike, and it's good to be here with you. I would say I've been talking about this problem for several years, many years now. And the reality is healthcare has a human problem. You know, we think of it as a technology problem, but it's a human problem because we're burning out our human workers. We are requiring them to do things because the systems don't talk to each other. We are putting them in between software, in between health systems, in between logical interfaces, to act as routers. So you're treating humans as routers. They're taking data in, they're taking data out, they're putting data into other systems. You know, they're extracting, they're transforming, they're loading data like a router would. And we have to stop treating humans like routers. And we have to start thinking about how we treat the human workers in healthcare.
Yeah, I appreciate that. And let's go there as well. So to springboard from that, Sean, we definitely need to discuss the important role of sound, innovative and useful technology can play in unleashing the human potential in the healthcare industry. Before I ask my question, of course, I want to tee up with some additional findings from the report. Executives say hiring is not enough to solve the problems the industry is facing. In fact, 64% say there will never be enough staff to handle the volume of data at the organization. But Sean, there is optimism that AI can help. 99% of executives say AI can empower employees to focus on more impactful work for patients and members. Here's some more exciting news. 93% of clinicians and 78% of administrative staff predict that AI will be good for their career. So I know you're very optimistic that technology and AI can play an important role in empowering humans. In fact, you recently shared a powerful and refreshing rally cry for the healthcare industry. You stated that healthcare should be the world's technology leader rather than lagging other industries. Can you unpack this a bit more? Why are you so passionate about this? How is this even possible? And how do we get there?
Well, you know, healthcare has the number one, is the number one employer in the United States. 16 million employees work in healthcare. And these are human workers. We have the greatest opportunity to increase the capacity of the human worker. We spend almost 9 billion hours right now with these administrative tasks. That's an enormous amount of human capacity that can be freed up. And in healthcare, we have the opportunity to show other industries what it can look like when we adopt and create technology to increase human capacity. Imagine increasing the ROI of a human worker, you know, having the, you know, more output for every single hour worked, having increased productivity, having decreased mistakes and errors, all that can happen with technology, and we're building it. I mean, the reality is we're already no longer the laggard in technology when it comes to automation. Healthcare is the shining light right now when it comes to enterprise automation. Healthcare is doing things that other industries are not. They're crossing new chasms. They're discovering new frontiers. Healthcare is figuring out how to apply automation across the entire enterprise to increase human capacity, building AI workers and an AI workforce that is unparalleled. Building AI coworkers, an AI coworker for every single human worker. This is absolutely doable, and we're already embarking on that path in the U.S. healthcare industry. It's important to me because this is about lives. It's about human lives, and we have this opportunity to create a healthcare system that changes the experience of health for every human. And we can do that with the capacity that we already have, so long as we're using technology, so long as we're connecting data together and we're using all the wisdom that we've generated over the years collectively, sharing it, making it accessible, making it come to the forefront when it's needed. All this is happening right now, and I'm very proud of the U.S. healthcare industry. You know, I think the days of really talking about where we're lacking should be over. Let's talk about where we're leading. Let's be that shining example. Let's create technologies that others want to adopt.
Thank you for that, Sean. And then also you mentioned earlier who we all serve, the lives, the patients, the consumer, the member. So let's go there for a moment as well. There were some key findings within the report that really shined a light on how critical technology is to best serve the patient and the consumer. The report highlighted that administrative staff suspect an average of 21% of patient records have at least one error, and 40% of clinicians predict AI will reduce the risk of misdiagnosis. So Sean, given what I just shared in regards to the importance technology plays in ensuring we are best serving patients, what's your take on the urgent need to deliver innovation to healthcare? Because as you and I know, lives depend on it.
You know, we sometimes forget, you know, in this industry, we sometimes forget when we go to these opulent conferences that a mile or 2 miles from where we're sitting, there's a family who's suffering. There's a hospital room with a kid who just got diagnosed with cancer. And there's a real problems. These are real issues, and they're facing real people every single day. And we have to remember that that's the industry we're in. We are there for them. We are there to reduce some of the uncertainty. We are there to create the efficiencies. We're there to make sure that the diagnosis is absolutely the best one. The information is available. We're there to remove some of that frustration that you feel when you go to the doctor and it feels like they don't know who you are or they haven't seen the information of your medical history. We have to change that. And it's a modern experience. It's one that we're used to. I mean, it's one that we're used to in every other thing that we encounter. We have this expectation of an experience in everything we do. That same experience will be delivered in healthcare. Consistency, information available to your providers, to your clinicians, to your nurses, to your caregivers, so that they can know who you are, so that they can have the history that is so important to your life and have all of the latest and greatest information about the diseases and the therapies and the drugs that exist. All of that is right around the corner. And it is absolutely going to change the human experience as it pertains to health. And I'm excited about that. And you know, whenever, again, I challenge us to say, like, you know, when we're at these events and conferences, don't forget why we're there. Don't forget that while we are enjoying ourselves in these very nice accommodations, that someone within a mile or two from where we're standing is suffering. And we have to do something about it.
Well, speaking of that, but then also looking forward, Sean, yes, we are in a dire situation. It is life and death. These are the people that we're serving across the country. And speaking of our nation, let's end on a high note. What does the Internet of Healthcare mean to you? And what does that look like for our country?
I think the ability to share all this incredible wisdom that we've been generating over many years, over decades in healthcare, is going to be super exciting. Imagine having at your fingertips all the wisdom that's been created in the U.S. healthcare system. Imagine having at your fingertips the data that you need to make great decisions, the information that you need to provide the best health experience you can to a patient. Imagine as a patient having complete transparency, knowing what to expect, not being confused, not being frustrated, and having access equitably to the best technologies. Whether you live in southeastern Ohio or New York City or the middle of Wyoming, having the exact same access to the latest and greatest technologies equitably across the country. That's what the IOH can provide, and that's what I'm just thrilled about. We are changing it. There's no one I would bet on more than the people who are right now working to do this in this industry. There's not a single industry that I think has the firepower that we have. And I'm very excited about the next decade and the promise of the IOH, which will change every single human's experience with health.